slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away.
Good morning, everybody.
Hello.
Hope everybody's having a happy and safe 4th.
Yes. And if you haven't experienced it already, I hope you've enjoyed your Freedom from British Oppression Day, 4th of July, 2015.
Or actually, since we've been looking into the laws and stuff of corporations and all
goodness.
That, technically the United States is still legally a British colony. So
yeah, so we're free from nothing, people. We're free from nothing.
Yes. So we're part of the British
Imperialism Day. Yeah. I don't know, whatever.
So shout out, you know, Tony, love you. To our kids, love you guys, you know, all of you. And Fairy Tale, dude, enjoyed talking to you.
Oh, man, I'm telling you.
Call us anytime.
You know how to lift a person's spirits, I'm telling you.
Yes, always makes me smile. Love his videos. Excellent job that you and Joel, the Unwitnessed, did. You know, if you guys haven't seen it yet, go check it out. They're called to the legal department. Oh, my goodness.
Talk about making a monkey's ass out of somebody. Here they got a lawyer. Here they got
supposedly.
Allegedly a lawyer on the other end of the line, and it's like unbelievable.
Crickets chirping.
Yeah. Yes.
And a shout out to Mark and Cora, you know, and not only everybody in the YouTube world, but Mark and Cora. Cora, heard you're sick, and hope for a speedy recovery, dear sister. Love you. One thing, I'm not a doctor, but one thing that might help is 100% pure eucalyptus oil. Rub it on your chest and your back a couple of times a day, and I know when he had fluid on the lungs.
Yeah, my mom was deathly afraid. You need to get him to a hospital
right
now.
Yeah, take him to
the
emergency room.
Go! And, a couple days later, eucalyptus oil, and it all cleared up. But the alternative is, Cora, the eucalyptus don't oil. Listen to me. Don't work. Try a couple shots of this with a couple aspirins. If this doesn't help, well, you're not going to much care anyways.
Wouldn't hurt.
So, that's it for that. Now we're going to go on to morning worship with Jehovah's Witnesses again.
Yeah. Well, that's why we have the song Slip Sliding Away, because we're hoping Watchtower is just kind of slip sliding away into oblivion. You know, we can always hope for that. But
well, this morning worship, I mean, again, Watchtower, we know you're watching our videos. How can you guys sit there and write out a script for morning worship that includes con artists selling the Brooklyn Bridge and how con artists change the perimeters of their con and not realize it's you that you're talking about? The only people that don't realize it are the sound asleep Jehovah's Witnesses. And just like the Watchmen, one day they're going to get caught asleep and they're going to get disrobed and their nakedness is going to be shown to the entire world. Jehovah's Witnesses, pay attention and wake up, because we're going to show you how these guys in their morning worship program are talking to you. They're not talking about the world. They're specifically talking to you. Watch how we can prove this.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
And it's not because we want to humiliate Jehovah's Witnesses that we hate Jehovah's Witnesses. I mean, it's not against the witnesses themselves. It's against your hierarchy and
the
cult leaders. You know, that is who, you know, we have issues with. We're actually trying to help you to get your freedom away from this cult. And this morning worship, all we seen was them talking about themselves. Almost everything they say in here is exactly what they're doing.
And we'll even use your own reference work, your reliable reference work. I mean, come on.
Yes.
I mean, if there was a con artist working in the neighborhood, making phone calls, trying to dupe you out of some of your money, wouldn't you appreciate a call from a couple of YouTubers saying, hey, watch out for this phone call because these guys are con artists? You would thank us for taking the time to do that. But yet, here you are. You've got the same technique right here on JW.org, and all you can do is bash us. And all we're trying to do is wake you up to the fact what they're saying applies to you.
Yeah, but thank you to all of the ones who do send us emails and make comments under in videos and stuff thanking us, you know, for helping them, you know, wake up and for videos and stuff. Because, you know, that's what keeps us going. It's like, okay, you know, we are helping some. And I also wanted to thank Lucy. Thank you, sweetie, because the 2010 Watchtower Bond volume that you sent me, not only does it have the subliminal image in it that I have been looking for with the fire-breathing dragon, but this is also the Watchtower that has the overlapping generations.
And we're going to be bringing that in this video to show how the con works.
Yes, exactly.
So let's just start making everybody sick and go get your barf bag or something, because it's... it's very apparent who they're talking about.
Yeah. So we'll watch the first clip.
Hoaxes, scams, and deceptions. What's the first thing usually that comes to your mind when you hear of a scam or a hoax? Well, many think of financial hoaxes, such as the sale of the Brooklyn Bridge. That bridge was built and completed actually in 1883, and according to reports, the years following its completion, there were a number of con men who sold it to people. In fact, in some cases, the people who thought they bought the bridge set up a toll booth, and they thought they were going to make a lot of money until the police came along and told them to remove the toll booth. And the con artists also made out official-looking papers. One, of course, I don't think sounded too official to me. It said, one bridge in good condition. And that's how it was sold. Well, that makes us laugh, I know. And we think we're too smart to ever be taken in by such a scam.
Jehovah's Witnesses, do you think that you're so smart that you couldn't be duped into buying a false, I don't know, bridge to paradise or something? Pay attention. Pay close attention, because we're going to show you how you were misled, how you were conned into believing something that just isn't going to happen.
We certainly hope we are. Nevertheless, there are wicked men and imposters who deceive people, and they're very skilled at the art of deception. And we have to face the fact that wicked men and imposters are capable of deceiving people who are very smart. It happens frequently. Paul wrote about this. Let's take our Bibles and turn to 2 Timothy chapter 3. We'll read verse 13. 2 Timothy 3:13. There the scripture says, "But wicked men and imposters will advance from bad to worse." And notice this last part, misleading and being misled. So they not only mislead, but they too are misled, especially when we think about knowledge of God and the influence of Satan on the world, who's misleading the entire inhabited earth.
Talking about themselves again, unbelievable.
And then to use a scripture from the Apostle Paul, do you not see that it applies to you? Wicked men and imposters will go from bad to worse. Here's an example. 1961, Jehovah's Witnesses, Watchtower Bible Tract Society printed in this booklet that taking blood fractions was against God's law. They've gone from bad to worse because in recent years, they flip-flopped that and now said that it is a conscience matter. Every one of them Jehovah's Witnesses that believed this con back then and lost their lives and died because of refusing a blood fraction that is now a conscience matter, Watchtower is blood guilty. That's how they've gone bad to worse because they actually implemented the con, and Jehovah's Witnesses lost their lives because of this con. They went from bad to worse. Now, as far as a little comment about, you know, those are misleading and being misled, I don't believe it for a minute.
Oh, well, go ahead, finish.
Well, just simply go back and watch the movie The Sting with Paul Newman and Robert Redford. Those guys knew exactly what they were doing throughout that movie as they were pulling off that con. They knew exactly what the outcome was going to be. They just had to find the right mark, which was Quincy from Jaws. What was that actor's name?
Robert Shaw?
Robert Shaw. Remember, he was the mark, right? See, they knew exactly what was going to happen. And Watchtower knew exactly what was going to happen here. They would have human sacrifices.
Well, what reminds me of that phrase when he said, you know, that they themselves would be deceived, it appears, at least in my personal opinion, that the governing body believes their crap so much that they have deceived themselves.
Yeah. But, okay, that's just one example. Let's listen to some more of this Ho-Ho-E-Paw and see what he has to say.
Is that a Native American word?
Yeah, that's Ho-Ho-E-Paw. I'm given to understand, and no disrespect at all to my Lakota Sioux brothers, but that terminology is supposed to mean bonehead. So let's listen more to this Ho-Ho-E-Paw.
Well, where are these wicked men found? Almost everywhere. It's common to hear of businessmen who swindle people out of millions upon millions of dollars. They're heartless, cruel in their thinking. And then there are some politicians who are notorious for diverting large amounts of money into the bank account of friends and family. But the worst, the biggest imposter, the biggest swindler in a sense, is Babylon the Great, the world empire of false religion. She is truly wicked, and she is an imposter because she pretends to be close to God, to represent God, and to help people come to have a relationship with our great God, Jehovah. She's misled the vast majority of the human family around the globe. And what's interesting about Babylon misleading people, not only her flock, but she's misled people who have become atheists because of her. How many millions of people don't believe in God? They've rejected not only false religion because they can't stomach her teachings or her moral or immoral conduct, better said, but they make the terrible mistake of rejecting everything, including the Creator.
Isn't it funny how this guy sits here and bashes Christendom and by extension the Catholic Church, and yet these guys can't comprehend that in, what, the 1980 Watchtower, they wrote an article saying that they know the name Jehovah is false and it comes from a Catholic monk.
Well, look at their last broadcast, you know, that talk that Jackson gave. I mean, you know, he was basically admitting that they know that's not the true pronunciation of God's name.
But here's the thing, Jehovah's Witnesses. Here's the con. You're supposed to have separated yourself from all false teachings associated with Babylon the Great, Christendom. But yet Watchtower leads you into believing that this name Jehovah is of divine inspiration from the very Catholic source, from the very Babylon the Great that you hate, now becomes yours and yours alone. Can you not see that that in itself is a con? My goodness. I mean, how much more do we need to spell this out before you begin to really wake up?
Well, not only that, but then he starts bashing, you know, the Catholic Church for making a bunch of atheists, you know.
Yeah.
But the thing is they don't realize that Watchtower has done a pretty good job of making a bunch of atheists too. You know, nothing against the atheists or agnostic beliefs.
Saying.
You know, that's not what we're saying. We're just looking at it, you know, from the way Watchtower is, oh, you know, the Catholic Church is making all these atheists. I believe Watchtower has done a fair share, you know, of that too.
Oh, absolutely. You only need to spend a little bit of time in the XJW community to see that there's truth behind the words that Kim and I are speaking. So Watchtower, you're just as guilty of doing the same thing you just accused the Catholic Church of doing. You're a hypocrite and you're a con artist. And who's ever sitting down writing this script for you has got their head so far up somebody's butt, you can't even recognize the truth of the words you're writing. I mean, my goodness, talk about a con conning a con. Jeez. Okay.
There's more.
As you know, the greatest and most enduring hoax ever perpetrated on the human family took place about 6,000 years ago. It was when a snake spoke to Eve. That was truly a hoax. In the Watchtower of January 1st, 2011, on page 12, some interesting thoughts are presented about the ways in which Satan may have manipulated matters so as to convince Eve of what he was about to tell her, to deny God, to be disobedient. Maybe you recall the article, "Where was the snake when it spoke to Eve?" Well, the Bible doesn't actually say, but some pictures depict it in a tree. Was it the tree of the knowledge of good and bad? And when the snake spoke to Eve, it shocked her, obviously, because she had lived in the Garden of Eden for some time, and she knew animals couldn't talk. Snakes couldn't talk, but this one started talking to her, and she believed it. Did it take a bite of the forbidden fruit? And because of that, was she allowed to gain this ability to speak? The Bible doesn't say. We don't know. These are just possibilities. But the
greatest hoax ever perpetrated on humankind.
Oh, my goodness.
Forget humankind. What about one of the greatest hoaxes that Watchtower and Babel Crap Society has perpetrated in modern day time?
Millions now living will never die.
Okay. Right straight from the reliable source. Page 97, under the heading of dates, about midway down. In the meantime, the very difficult conditions foretold for the last days would prevail. As shown under the heading last days, those events have been clearly in evidence since 1914. Before the last members of the generation that was alive in 1914 will have passed off the scene, all the things foretold will occur, including the Great Tribulation in which the present wicked world would pass away. Then it goes on with another subheading, "When will the end of the wicked world come?" Jesus answered, "Concerning that day and hour, nobody knows, neither the angels of the heavens nor the Son, but only the Father." However, he also stated, "Truly I say to you that this generation," and in the brackets game, it says, "that was alive when the sign of the last days began its fulfillment, will by no means pass away until all these things occur." Okay, so now, those events have been clearly in evidence since 1914. Before the last members of the generation that was alive in 1914 will have passed off the scene, all the things foretold will occur, including the Great Tribulation in which the present wicked world will end. Well, there's the con speech.
What happened when they started dying off and there wasn't too many left?
And now that we're 100 years past that time point, how has the con changed? How has the deception changed?
That's when we get into the 2010 Watchtower. Got a little confused with the Watchtower we used before.
Now, Jehovah's Witnesses, remember, that generation will by no means pass away until all these... Well, that generation, by all means, is dead and gone. So now how do these con artists redefine the terms of the con to keep you in the game?
Yep, and that's where the 2010 Watchtower comes in. This is from the April 15th, page 10. 10.
Now remember, Jehovah's Witnesses, this is your own reliable source.
This is the hard copy itself. This is not online that can be altered by, you know, those evil apostates.
That's right. Apostates can't alter this.
Yeah. Okay, so page 10. By being obedient and loyal to the direction received from the earthly part of God's organization, you show that you are keeping pace with Jehovah's celestial chariot and are working in harmony with His Holy Spirit. So, paragraph 13, about halfway down.
So, basically, when they say they're keeping pace with Jehovah's celestial chariot, what they're saying is that you need to keep pace with the Khan.
Yeah. For example, considering our understanding of those who make up this generation mentioned by Jesus. It doesn't say the Bible's understanding.
Or it doesn't say the understanding coming from Jehovah's celestial chariot.
Or from the Holy Spirit. Oh no, yeah. It's
our understanding. See, do you guys not think about what you're writing? Because you're telling the whole world of JWism that you're being directed by God's Holy Spirit. If you're being directed by God's Holy Spirit, then conclusively you should not be saying our understanding.
Yeah. So paragraph 14, about halfway down, is when the con starts. He evidently meant that the lives of the anointed who were on hand when the sign began to become evident in 1914 would overlap with the lives of other anointed ones who would see the start of the Great Tribulation.
Okay. But in contradiction, okay, before the last members of the generation that was alive in 1914 will have passed off, all the things foretold will occur, including the start of the Great Tribulation. Now the perimeters of the con are changing to overlapping generations.
Yeah. Now it's ones that the lives of the anointed who were on hand when the sign began would overlap the lives of other anointed ones who would see the start of the Great Tribulation. That generation had a beginning and it surely will have an end. The fulfillment of the various features of the sign clearly indicates that the tribulation must be near. By maintaining your sense of urgency and keeping on the watch, you show that you are keeping up with advancing light and following the leadings of Holy Spirit.
Keeping up with the con. But see, here again, this is a contradiction from the writer's pen. See, you show that you are keeping up with advancing light and following the leadings of the Holy Spirit. But down here, it said, he speaking about how then are we to understand Jesus' words about this generation? He evidently meant, wait a minute, how come the Holy Spirit is not conclusively saying Jesus meant for sure and for certain that the lives of the anointed who were on hand that saw, see, you're not using absolute positive connecting words by saying he evidently. All you're doing, Watchtower, is you're grasping at straws as you try to keep the con in continuation.
Well, the reason they just say evidently and perhaps and all of those
because
words,
they don't know.
Well, look at what they did in the reasoning book. Definitely.
Yeah.
And then they're shown to be con artists, so
yeah,
they can't use words like that anymore.
Just like in the Harp of God, in the last video, Rutherford wrote something, some bullcrap about how the beginning of the end started with the Napoleonic Wars. It's proof positive, Jehovah's Witnesses, that we were in the beginning of the end since 1799, and Jesus' second appearance was in 1874.
So that's why they can't say definitely, and you know this has happened. And
but they say that, but then they say right here, by maintaining your sense of urgency and keeping on the watch, you show that you are keeping up with advancing light and following the leadings of the Holy Spirit. That's an absolute, conclusive, convicting statement. But yet, in contrast, they say this is our understanding. Evidently, you guys are freaking Confucianists.
Well, okay, so while you're, you know, waving this around, I just happen to look down here at paragraph 16 in this, under the subheading, Holy Spirit's role in the future. In the future, Jehovah will employ his Holy Spirit in remarkable ways to accomplish the fulfillment of his purpose. Consider first the matter of protection. As we have seen, Jehovah used his Spirit in the past to protect individuals as well as the nation of Israel as a whole. What's interesting is I was just talking to Jerry Jones, and he's done a video where he has found where they have said that Jehovah protected Enoch, but he did not protect Abel.
Yeah.
So it's like Abel was the first witness of Jehovah's. Why wouldn't he protect the first witness of his on the planet then and protect Enoch? You know, well, it doesn't make sense.
Here's some more from the, I'm going to rename this to the Con Artist Rule Book. So going on, hence, we have every reason to believe that he will use that same powerful spirit to protect his people during the approaching Great Tribulation. We need not speculate about exactly how Jehovah will care for us then. Rather, we can look to the future with confidence, knowing that lovers of Jehovah will never be hidden from his view or beyond the reach of his Holy Spirit. But we have every reason to believe. Where's your conclusive proof that God's going to protect you? Like Kim just mentioned, there was no proof that God was even interested in protecting Cain when Cain slaughtered him. But yet the book of Enoch shows that Jehovah's loving concern protected Enoch? It sounds like your God Jehovah is helping you confusionists. And another thing regarding Cain and Abel, answer this question, Jehovah's Witnesses. Okay, God didn't do anything to protect Abel. He let Cain slaughter Abel. Okay, so drop down to verse, chapter 4, Genesis chapter 4, verse 9. Later on, Jehovah said to Cain, "Where is Abel, your brother?" And he said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's guardian?" At this, he said, What have you done? Listen, your brother's blood is crying out to me from the ground. And now you are cursed in abandonment from the ground, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood at your hand. When you cultivate the ground, it will not give you back its power. A wanderer and a fugitive, you will be coming to earth. At this, Cain said to Jehovah, "My punishment for error is too great to carry. Here you are actually driving me this day from off the surface of the ground, and from your face I shall be concealed, and I must become a wanderer and fugitive on the earth, and it is certain that anyone finding me will kill me." Okay? Keep in mind, Cain just murdered Abel. And what does Jehovah do? Jehovah, listening to his pleas, at this Jehovah said to him, "For that reason, anyone killing Cain must suffer vengeance 7 times. And also Jehovah set up a sign for Cain in order that no one finding him should strike him. Wow.
So he protects Cain.
Jehovah God just protected Cain. What about Jehovah's law, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth? Why didn't God put Cain to death at that moment? Jehovah's justice is exact. It's always been the same from the beginning until now. So why is this scripture written in the way that Jehovah doesn't even avenge the murder of Abel, but yet he protects the murderer himself? Come on, Jehovah's Witnesses. Your God, Jehovah, is as much a confusionist as you are. Figure it out.
Yeah. Well, then I have another question. We have the clip from that 2015 regional convention where that elder was saying, he's talking about Jesus cleansing the temple.
Yeah.
You know, And, you know, worshiping at the temple, even though the Pharisees were corrupt. And then he says, and we still have to worship at Jehovah's approved, you know, kingdom halls, no matter what abuse we may see. Okay? And we all know that witness's famous thing, when you see abuse going on, is wait on Jehovah.
Wait on Jehovah.
Okay,
yeah.
Then I have a question. If Jehovah, your God Jehovah, cannot clean out the kingdom halls now and do away with this abuse and prevent the raping of children, how do you expect him to save you through the Great Tribulation?
He's not saving you now. Think about it. See, you're being conned. You're being duped into believing what these wicked men are saying. And yet, I can just say, oh, this morning worship was so, so faith-strengthening. And you can't even comprehend how they continue to manipulate your mind into believing what they have to say. They manipulated your mind here, including the Great Tribulation, in which this present wicked world will pass. That generation is gone, Jehovah's Witnesses, and now they're duping you into believing that, oh, we misunderstood. Jesus evidently meant that the generations would overlap. My goodness.
I love, in Evie and her video, she always calls it the mind screw.
Unscrewing the mind.
That's exactly what they're doing to people.
Yeah. So do we have more from this Hohoe Pa?
Yep.
Okay.
That almost sounds like too good of a word for him.
It does, but he's still a bonehead.
What a terrible, cruel hoax. And that same hoax, basically, the teaching has been perpetrated throughout the planet. We want to keep our reason, be balanced, be discerning, and please, don't buy the Brooklyn Bridge.
Don't buy the Brooklyn Bridge. Yeah, Jehovah's Witnesses, I hate to tell you this, but you buy it every week.
Every week you buy the Brooklyn Bridge.
Yeah. Now, the last video we did, we had mentioned about their expansion program, you know, they're going to be doing with building kingdom halls. And it's not really, it may look like dwindling attendance, but it's not. It's really an expansion program.
So con we talk.
Yeah, it's the con is on, you know. So we want to thank George Miller. He has been doing some research, and he sent us some information in regards to that. But it also fits in nicely with our con is on.
That's right.
So you may all remember this, the Revelation book that we studied how many?
Oh, 3-4 times at least.
Oh, my
goodness.
Goodness.
And now most of it's outdated information.
Yeah. And Mark and Cora did a video about the Tippex. I think that here in this country it's called
white out.
Yeah, you know, where you white out and then you have to, like, put in the new information.
Sorry.
Yep. Yeah. Not enough arms on the chair
here. Little tight quarters.
Okay, so in the Revelation book here on page 228, and I don't know if the pages would be the same for every version, but this is the 1988, the original. Okay, so on page 229, what's interesting is they're talking about Christendom's waters drying up, and they, you know, I'll just read it. In ancient Babylon's heyday, the abundant waters of the Euphrates were a major part of her defense system. In 539 BCE, those waters dried up when they were diverted from their course by the Persian leader Cyrus. Thus, the way was open for Cyrus the Persian and Darius the Mede, the kings from the rising of the sun, that is, the east, to enter Babylon and conquer it. In the hour of crisis, the river Euphrates failed in the defense of that great city. Something similar is due to happen to modern Babylon, the worldwide system of false religion. Paragraph 22. Babylon the Great sits on many waters. According to Revelation 17, 1 and 15, these symbolize peoples and crowds and nations and tongues, hordes of adherents that she has regarded as a protection. But the waters are drying up. In Western Europe, where formerly she had great influence, hundreds of millions have openly ignored religion. It just goes on to talk about how Babylon the Great is drying up. And it says, similarly, when the time comes for Babylon the Great to be destroyed, the dwindling number of her adherents will prove to be no protection at all. Though she claims a membership of thousands of millions, Babylon the Great will find herself defenseless against the kings from the rising of the sun.
Your water's drying up, Watchtower? Keep in mind, this is just a small representation of those that are leaving Watchtower. So in a very realistic way, your waters are drying up. It seems to me like all you have now is just a couple little pools here and there of witnesses that still believe you're con.
Yes. And in the Isaiah book, this is volume 2, page 74, paragraph 25, about, two-thirds of the way down. Just as Babylon's protective waterways failed to save her from Cyrus, so the waters of mankind that support and protect Babylon the Great will be dried up before she is justly destroyed.
But you didn't read that right. Remember, we rehearsed this. I can't believe you forgot this, dear. My goodness. This is what it should read. Just as Babylon's protective waters failed to save her from Cyrus, so the waters of mankind that support the Watchtower Bible Tract Society will be dried up just before she is justly destroyed. Oh, my goodness. See, that's how it should read. See, Watchtower, your waters, your people are leaving by the droves. Remember that little cricket scene earlier in the video, that Kingdom Hall? Go back and count how many empty seats are in that Kingdom Hall. I'll almost bet that that picture was taken during one of their memorial occasions.
Could be. Well, you know, and I just noticed back here in the Revelation book, paragraph 23, it says how Darius the Mede and Cyrus the Persian were used by Jehovah to conquer the ancient city of Babylon. And then it says, in this, the Lord's Day, the false religious system of Babylon the Great will also be destroyed by human rulers. But again, this will be a divine judgment. Jehovah God and Jesus Christ, the kings from the rising of the sun, will have put it into the hearts of human rulers, the thought.
I just thought of something. I'm going off the cuff right now.
No, you're trying to knock over the camera.
Yeah. Okay, where did you just read from?
Right there, paragraph 23.
Okay, but who are these kings? And Father and Cyrus and the Persian, Darius the Mede, Babylon, right?
Human rulers.
In this, the Lord's Day, the false religious system of Babylon the Great, which now is to include Watchtower Bible Tract Society, Great will also be destroyed by human rulers. But again, this will be divine judgment. Well, you know, Watchtower Bible Tract Society, you are not going to be destroyed by human rulers. You know what's going to destroy you? Your own words, your own reference material. While you're sitting back cleverly wording all of this propaganda to paint a picture that applies to Babylon the Great or even Christendom, you can't comprehend that by extension, you're doing the same very thing to you. Jesus said, do unto others as you would have them do to you. While you're writing all of these words that are pointing the finger at Christendom, those same words that you write are now coming back to destroy you.
The thing is when you're pointing at somebody, there's three fingers pointing back at you.
Well, here's the thing. Back in our day, you know, when we were thinking about that generation that will not pass away, we're thinking, okay, the scriptures in Psalms say that that generation, 70 years, 80 by special might. And we're thinking, okay, 80 years from 1914, that brings us up to 1975, 1980. Oh, that 94? Generation's getting older. 94, that generation's getting older. Oh, my goodness. We're so close. And then you say again, this generation will by no means pass away. And now we come, well, but you got to remember, during all of that time period in our day, Watchtower, you were redefining the con. Because see, at first, You said they would have had to been at the age of understanding, which was what, maybe 14, 15 years old, which means that it had to been born in 1899 or 1900 to be 14 by 1914 in the age of understanding. And then all of a sudden, as we started getting closer to those, dying and going, we have to redefine. Evidently, Jesus meant that that age of understanding was 10. So you bought yourself a couple more years. A couple more years go by.
And then it's like, science has proven that kids start to have memories at the age of 3 or 4. So 3 or 4 would have been a good age.
Yeah. So now what you've done is you've just shrunk your con to where your con is going to disappear. And now,
that's why they had to do the new con.
Yeah, that's the only way that you can keep these people conned into your belief system. Because trust me, Watchtower, when I say this, trust me. When we were sitting in that Kingdom Hall and we was reading this Watchtower and you were trying to do the overlapping generation, there wasn't one single Jehovah Witness in this world that sat there and heard that and say, oh my God, this proves we're right at the edge. No, they were saying, oh my God, that means the system could go on for another 10, 20, 30 years.
50 years. There's a lot.
That's why people are leaving, because now they recognize the con job that you're pulling on people. And the only ones that are remaining are the ones that are too stupid to figure out what the hell you're doing.
Or the new ones that don't have the history.
Yeah, because in our day, I go back, just to reiterate, okay, that generation, the age of understanding, 14, then you dropped it to 10, then you dropped it to 6 or 5. You bought yourself a couple more years. Now you got to the point to where you can't buy another couple of years, so now you have to extend Jesus evidently meant that this generation would overlap. My goodness, you people are so stupid that you can't figure this out, that you're being conned. My goodness, how in the world can these writers sit there and continue to write, redefine the perimeters of how the Brooklyn Bridge is going to get sold, and the Jehovah Witness sits in there and say, oh, wasn't this a really encouraging morning worship?
And jeez. And what's interesting is, as Jehovah's Witnesses, it never dawned on us that Jesus was talking to people at that time period in person and met that generation that he was talking to. It never dawned on us.
Because that generation that Jesus was referring to was the generation in his day. Because that generation didn't pass away before Jerusalem was destroyed.
They did get
in 70 CE. They did get to see it.
But as Jehovah's Witnesses, we never even thought about that.
No. So, Jehovah's Witnesses, stop being stupid people and start thinking for yourself. Start comprehending how Watchtower is screwing with your minds, how they're manipulating your life away from you, thinking that you're serving God and you're following Watchtower. The minute Watchtower flip-flops a doctrine or tries to redefine what a doctrine is, you're being conned.
And it's interesting because I had sent the link to this morning worship to Deep Throat, and he wrote back, and he says, oh, Brother William Malignafart.
Yeah.
You know, and Brother Malignafart, you know, says at the end, you know, have insight, have discernment, you know, however he words it, you know. It's like witnesses, that's all we're asking. Just have a little bit of insight, you know. Just use your reasoning power that you are being conned.
Yeah, that's why God created you with a brain that works. Start using it.
Yes.
My goodness.
So we hope you all are having a happy 4th of July.
Yeah.
And
I am.
Oh, yeah, I got a good rant in. Kids came to see us, and we've talked to several other people, and we still have more phone calls to make. But welcome to all our new subscribers, and thank you, everyone, for watching our videos.
Welcome to our brand of insanity, huh?
Oh, yeah. It just gets crazier and crazier. Let me tell you.
You know, we're the two apostates that you just love to hate. I don't know. Maybe somewhere along the line, I think somebody even called us a fart in the wind, huh?
This sounds familiar.
We ain't going anywhere, Jehovah's Witnesses. We're here for the duration.
Yes.
You know, we realize we're not going to close Watchtower's doors down, but boy, we're going to be mighty close to it when they start crumbling. That's for sure. Because you, Watchtower, you just can't continue the last printing the crap and the garbage that you're printing. You just can't last that long because everybody is beginning to see it. The internet is going to close your doors.
And tomorrow we should have the July 2015 broadcast up and running. So I'm sure you'll be hearing more from us soon.
Soon. Like Armageddon. Soon.
You all have a great
bye.
Still crazy after all these years. Oh, still crazy.